Congress.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I want to thank you, one, for all of the work that's happened on the committee so far, and I wanted to speak in support of all four resolutions, but specifically in H.R. 131. And wanted to thank the ranking member and also Chairman Smith for his longstanding leadership on this issue. All of us know that the crisis in the Congo has gone unresolved for so many years. We've seen numerous declarations and agreements for peace, yet too little has been done to prevent the death of millions and the displacement of those forced to flee their homes and livelihood. I'm pleased that this bipartisan bill has many, many co-sponsors who've also registered their strong support to end the status quo. Over the last several months, I'm pleased to report that we've seen the United Nations appoint a special envoy to the DRC, former Irish President Mary Robinson, and last week, Secretary Kerry appointed former Senator Russ Feingold as the UN Special Envoy to the DRC, and that's one of the things that the resolution was calling for, was the appointment of that special envoy. I had the opportunity to speak to Senator Feingold yesterday, and I'm sure that the chair and ranking member has also, and I think it might be a great idea down the line after he's had a chance to settle in if we would ask him to come and give us a report to the committee. In February, the Congolese, joined by other Great Lakes nations as well as the UN and African Union, committed to an agreement that, with the strong support from the international community, hopefully will finally lead to peace and stability. This committee has the opportunity and responsibility to send a clear message that the ongoing crisis in the DRC has not been forgotten in this chamber or in the U.S. Congress. It's time for the crisis in the DRC to come to an end, and I really appreciate my colleagues' support in our efforts to end this tragedy. I yield back my time.
Thank you.